Fiction, on this special episode, we're going to look ahead. That's right, Jen C. Jacob and his colleague Karen Ribello from Boom have spent the entire week peering into a crystal ball, trying to figure out what's going to happen with fake news in 2018. All right, without further ado, let's get started with 2018's Fake News Outlook. First up, we're predicting that 2018 will be the year that fake news swings state elections. Jen C., it's a worrying trend. We've seen this happen already. But in your estimation, it's only going to get worse, is it?
So, you know, look at this. 2018, we've got 8 state elections. You know, now 8 is not, look at Karnataka, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Chhattisgarh, and several northeastern states. We've already seen what has happened in Gujarat, where there were a lot of stories which went up. The entire IT division of all these political parties were up, on social
working
media.
Working 24-7.
24-7, they were working on it. No less than the Prime Minister himself, Narendra Modi. He was leading this campaign in Gujarat, and we saw the kind of communal divisive politics that Gujarat had, you know, descended to. So, the more of it we are predicting this year, since 8 state elections are happening, some of the real big states, one big state in Karnataka where Congress is trying to defend its turf, and the other 3 big states where the BJP has to ensure that they do not lose those states. A lot of this battle is going to spill on social media, a lot of it on WhatsApp, Facebook, Twitter, and it's going to be an ugly battle. And that is why we are there to actually keep an eye and to figure out what of those images and those videos are true or fake.
These IT sales are going to have a very busy 2018, clearly. All right, next up, we're predicting that real news will fall more often for fake news. Jen C., we've already seen reputable news sources, major news agencies fall for fake news in 2017. I would have thought that would make them more wary and made it less likely for it to happen again in 2018, but you're saying it's going to happen more often.
So, see, Suyash, with the democratization of how images and videos and news is being consumed on social media, what we're going to see is that as more and more, if the newsrooms are actually going to rely on lazy, you know, desk writing and curating, you know, that word curation, right, which actually became the replacement of doing good journalism. As more and more newsrooms do that, you'll find that more and more reputable newsrooms whose dependence on web desks to find out, you know, okay, what is trending today, look at Google Trends, pick up the story, look at 4 sources, add keywords and push out the story. That is going to be a real danger game. There was a time when it really paid rich dividends, gave you a lot of page views. You could ramp up your page views and say that, you know, there are so many people reading your stories. But this is going to be very difficult. 2017 has already shown us, name the organization, and they have all fallen for it. They all had to pull back those stories. If you're going to rely on curation, and if your only game is going to be about how you're going to pick up keywords and stories and write a different version of it, you will see more and more newsrooms falling for this.
All right, next up is the impact fake news can have on brands. We've all seen the plastic rice videos and so many other WhatsApp stories and forwards that directly target brands. Jen C., you think this is a trend that's going to get even bigger in 2018?
Yes, Suyash. In fact, there's a lot of misconception that fake news can only create communal tension. Yes, that's a major part of it. Right. But it is also true that fake news impacts brands in a very big way. Last year, we started with this entire Jet Airways story where there were these forwards going about videos where, you know, some plane was catching fire and, you know, it ultimately turned out to be a fire drill, no connection with Jet Airways. Then we also saw that during this entire scare of plastic rice, several basmati rice brands, their business was affected in the Middle East at that time.
Now videos of people rolling up balls of rice and throwing it in
the wall.
In fact,
one of the rice brands also had to go and bring in a court injunction against the videos. You know, right, that's the kind of impact it had. Then we also saw Sanofi Aventis constantly engaging with the media, telling them about the fact that Combiflam is safe to be consumed and, you know, nothing is going to happen. And all the news that was coming, it was related to 2015, about an old batch. Right. So finally, I think companies have realized that fake news is not something that does not affect them. In fact, it affects their business, their bottom line, in a very big way, which is why they'll have to engage more and more with fact checkers like us and also with their own customers and constantly keep speaking to them, telling them about which videos and images you should not be believing at all and should be keeping away from.
Right, so 2018 is going to be the year budgets will have to be set aside just to battle fake news. Opportunism is the only true tenant of fake news, which is why we so often see it in the midst of a tragedy. Gen Z, what do we need to be looking for in the aftermath of a terror attack or an attack of that sort in 2018?
So again, you know, when we look back in 2017, we saw that across Europe, there were several terror attacks that happened, you know, many unfortunate attacks where people have died in large numbers. The one thing that we've seen then, and we feel that more of it will happen now in 2018 as well, whenever a terror attack happens, is this trend of these very retweet hungry trolls who feel that, you know, they need to pull up an image from here and there, and they'll say, oh, my brother is missing, you know, can someone locate him? So immediately people will start retweeting it, you know. Now, I don't know what's the thrill they get out of this, but several of them were called out for this purpose. Secondly, even before the police has come out with any pointers about who the attacker could be, there are several of them who come on Twitter and they will say that you know there were these someone calling out some religious slogan during when this attack was happening, and they'll start speculating about putting out some random images of some of a person from a particular religion. There are so many of them have happened, and many of them have been proven to be false.
Completely unverified information, just someone making something up and throwing it out.
And Twitter, there are people who are randomly, and several journalists have fallen for this in 2017 as well. We've seen they've gone and shared this, and ultimately it doesn't turn out to be true, which is why the first thing that we do whenever there is a terror attack that happens, we keep an eye on all these images that are coming in. In fact, one advice for all the news channels is don't use any unverified videos or images. Right. You know, it's very easy to say that, you know, oh, it came in and live news situation, we have put it out. But there are several people who are ready to play mischief, and that is what you need to be careful about.
Good advice for news channels, and good advice for you. Do not share things at sensitive times unless you're sure it's real information. Cybersecurity has certainly become a hot button issue this past year, with several attacks happening around the world. Gen Z, what's the fake news brigade likely to do when the next cybersecurity attack happens?
So again, going back to 2017, remember WannaCry, you know, that digital extortion ransomware. How many messages we received the entire year talking about, you know, don't click on this message or click on this link and you'll be...
Secure yourself against WannaCry, you know, or don't do this to click
So many of them. So which is why we feel now everyone is talking about this buzzword called artificial intelligence. No. And there's a scare about artificial intelligence taking away your jobs and all of that, which is why we feel that this is going to be a lot of fake news forwards are going to be around artificial intelligence and what it can do and what you should be avoiding. They will point out to certain links which they will give in the WhatsApp forwards, and they'll tell you, click here and we'll tell you, you know, what can be done. So several of these forwards we are going to see in 2018.
Stoking tech paranoia is certainly easy to do and very effective, but if it sounds like science fiction, it probably is. So keep an eye out. We've already seen what fake news can do during a natural disaster, and Mumbai was a prime example of this just a few weeks ago, right here, when reputed news agencies fell for fake footage. Gen Z, what does your crystal ball tell you? What's going to happen in 2018 when, if, and we hope it doesn't, but when a natural disaster strikes?
So, you know, as when we are trying to look forward, we do not want any natural disasters to happen, you know, of course. But, you know, there's so many videos and images that are already in circulation on WhatsApp and various other social media sites that we see. Now, we have tried to figure out why is it that despite the fact that people do know that many of these images and videos could be false, I've asked many of my friends and they have told me that, you know, kya bigadne wala hai, you know, let me just put it out. At the end of the day, it's only one person I'm sending it to.
Yeah, the classic forwarded as received.
Yes, you know, forwarded as received, you know. In fact, but those Suyash, these days I don't see that message, you know, at the end of the day. So
yeah,
I think, you know,
that's still happening on my Facebook, okay. By the way. It's
so
very
probably
annoying.
People are not sending it to me, but yeah, it's going
very, very annoying. Know. Stop doing that. If you're forwarding it, you are approving it.
Right.
Don't.
Right. So I do feel that the more and more these kind of videos are circulating, you will end up, like for example, the recent floods that we saw and the cyclone Oki that we saw, there might be many videos which actually we haven't seen. So someone somewhere might be storing it so that tomorrow if something like this happens, they'll put it out.
For the next cyclone, wherever the heck else it
happens. Yes, and which is why I always tell people that don't forward anything if you're not sure. You know, check with some journalist you might know, or go in Google search. You know, many of these things are available on Google. You really don't need to have really advanced knowledge. You can do certain basic checks yourself or otherwise send it to people like us. We are available on Twitter and Facebook.
And WhatsApp.
Yes.
And of course, when the disaster is happening in your city, this kind of information can become downright dangerous. So make sure you fact check everything you read. Almost every week, we cover a story that's inherently and maliciously communal in nature. Gen Z, I don't even need a crystal ball for this one. It's only going to get worse, right?
It's going to get worse because if we also see the politics around the world, more and more countries are becoming extremely populist in terms of their governments that that they're electing there. There's a lot of right-wing conservative parties who are seeing a lot of popularity because at the end of the day, people are saying globalization at the end of the day may not be a great idea because our people do not have jobs.
And outsiders
are coming and taking away our jobs.
And the migrant and refugee crisis has definitely stoked that fire.
Yes, you know,
as
the
well.
Rohingyas we saw in 2017 as a classic example.
Yes.
So a lot of hatred against religious and ethnic minorities. We'll see more of it in 2018 because at the end of the day, the world is not getting any better in terms of fulfilling the aspirations of the local people. So you'll see more of them actually hitting back against whom they perceive as taking away their rights and probably their rightful share of what they should be getting in terms of a booming economy. So more of it we'll see in 2018, which is why, you know, it's very important to say this, which is why Facebook and Twitter and all these tech companies need to come out with really sharp algorithms which will be able to weed them out, you know, weed out all these hatred and all these posts that are coming and using their tech platform so that more and more people are becoming part of this divisive hatred and probably attacking others, right? So tech companies have a huge responsibility here, and that's why we're looking forward to see what they will do this year.
Right. While Facebook has said that they are working on algorithms for eliminating fake news, the urgency of this may be underplayed because this kind of news, this kind of fakery can lead to serious issues and sometimes, as we've seen, violence. Now, some of my favorite stories on this show are the ones that involve copy-pasted tweets. Just because of their absolute lack of effort, the absolute paramount of laziness. Gen Z, the fake trending topics are just going to get more popular, aren't they?
Yes, that's true. And in fact, BJP, I should say, they mastered the art as far as
this is
concerned.
Yeah, they're the kings of it. They are the true connoisseurs.
They are kings of social media. But as far as this hashtag trending and also templated tweets where you just have to cut, copy, paste, they're mastered.
Control-C, Control-V.
Hats off to you, BJP.
BJP IT cell is master.
But let me also tell you, the Congress is also picking up on this. You know, the other parties are also picking up.
They're catching up finally on...
Everyone is catching up. In fact, the one of the...
They figured out the keyboard shortcut this year.
Yeah, that's
true. And now they're running with it.
One of the recent stories we did is about, when Anil Ambani actually and his group of companies, they came out of this entire debt restructuring program.
Yeah.
And we saw, and we did the story as well, how suddenly you saw random people who had nothing to do with probably any of the Reliance Group companies suddenly tweeting out saying that you know what a great man Anil Ambani is and really putting out. You know, we contacted the company and we asked them, are you guys doing this? They said, no, sorry, we don't even have a social digital marketing company. We believe you at the end of the day. But, you know, it was there, out there, you know, and we really counted it and we went up to about 100 tweets which had come up. Which were right, you know, one after the other,
straight,
not a comma
copy,
out,
straight copy,
not a
paste,
full stop,
not
out,
a punctuation out of place.
Yes, and they were like, you know, pasted there, and many of them actually out on Facebook, they really give an alert as well to all their friends, saying that at this time we are going to put out this trend, and this is the text. You just have to cut, copy, paste, and put it out. You know? So this we'll see more of it because also of the elections that are going to come in.
I mean, we're laughing about this, but these are coordinated social media events, essentially, now. And the negative effects of them can be massive, really. So I know we're laughing about this and we're treating it like a like news story, but this can really have serious consequences. India is the land of many, many languages. So it only makes sense, then, that fake news would adapt to meet this requirement. Gen Z, is fake news going to go multilingual and hyperlocal in 2018?
And that's the challenge for all those fake news busters like us and, you know, fact-checking websites. Because at the end of the day, with 200, 250 million WhatsApp users and only increasing, the challenge being that English is a very small, it's a very minuscule part of the entire ecosystem, you know. And you have family groups, you know, all of us have families, you know, where we have these very
the,
small...
The family WhatsApp group, yes.
Yeah,
the
and they're amazing,
existence.
Right? At the end of the day, you get to know so many things which you didn't even imagine it exists.
We could start a Marathi fact or fiction just on the basis of my own family WhatsApp group.
That's
just
true. And it's
non-stop fake news.
And I'm sure, you know, I can do it in Malayalam as well at the end of the day. So this is the big challenge at the end of the day. Language, you know, now how do you bust these because you're not see WhatsApp is encrypted at the end of the day. You can't really go into these groups and figure out what is being pushed out. Yes, and which is why more and more people, in fact the regional newspapers and the web channels, they need to get into this game at the end of the day. Because they have the proximity that they have in trying in understanding the local flavor and how these images and videos are going viral. That's going to be the biggest challenge even for media organizations, because they need to identify that this is a big market where they need to capture that space and tell them, you know, that this is not good. You're doing public service at the end of the day. And that's going to be the biggest challenge this year.
So local news channels, rather than falling for fake news, they start calling it out and explain to people the dangers of sharing it. And finally, the question we all want answered. Will WhatsApp remain the crown prince of fake news platforms? Or is there a successor in waiting? Gen Z, tell us, what do you think?
In fact, Suyash, when we spoke to Facebook sometime back, this is the first thing that we asked them. Y'all can do everything about Facebook, you know. You can put out an indicator, you can push up the stories that we do whenever there is a fake news story. What are you going to do about WhatsApp? As I said earlier, WhatsApp is encrypted. You can't enter those groups to figure out what is happening at the end of the day. Now, that is good for privacy at the end of the day, and we all want privacy. But also, what about fake news? So that's going to be the biggest challenge. But, you know, Suyash, till some time back, WhatsApp ecosystem was one, Twitter ecosystem was one, and Facebook ecosystem was one. Now, all of this is converging.
Yeah.
What you see on WhatsApp, in no time, you'll also see it on Twitter. You'll also see it on Facebook.
There's a screenshot up almost immediately on someone's Twitter account.
And the more easy it becomes to actually take images and push up into various, the software that you have and various platforms you have, it's going to become more easy for people to push out these things. And which is why we are increasingly seeing a trend that no longer something that we see on WhatsApp, we are not seeing on the other mediums. You know, it's seamless and it's going across all mediums. Which is why if you have all the three apps, on your phone, the one easy tip that I can give you, if when you receive an image or a video, go and check on Twitter and Facebook also whether this is available there or not. And by the kind of people who are sharing it, you can actually make out, you know, that this is not worth forwarding. But that's the, you know, most easiest way that you can do this.
Right, so fake news is truly going multi-platform, which means you need to be more aware. To sum it all up, I know things look bleak, I know it looks like you need to be paranoid about everything you read and hear, but that's not the case. Look, the fake news brigade is not a team of rocket scientists. Their fakery can be easily pointed out, as we've proved over the past few months. All you need is a keen eye, a little application of common sense, and sometimes just a Google search. Alright, that does it for our look ahead. You can find each of the stories we've covered today on boomlive.in. You already know where to follow us. You can also subscribe to our Boom Live broadcast by WhatsApping us on this number. You can also use that number to WhatsApp us a story that looks dubious or you think might be fake, so we can tell you whether it's fact or fiction. Thanks so much. Have a great start to this year, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.